Welcome back to a fantastic Friday episode. If you like this episode, be sure to hit the subscribe button. When people talk about if I could go back to when I was a teenager or when I was 20 or when I was 25 or whatever age, knowing what I know now, how different would my life look? I want for you that now, as much as possible, for myself as well. You can't see into the future. We don't know what's going to happen. However, we can take notes and lessons and listen to those who've gone before us and learn from them. And that's a large part of the reason I do the Heart Healthy Hustle, is to bring those lessons to you and selfishly for myself to learn from, so that I can expedite that process and show up as the 10-year future version of myself, or even 20-year future version of myself. Yeah, it does come with some changes, because you recognize, you still embrace the season of life that I'm in. One of the keys for me to living a full life, one of them, has been to focus in every aspect of life and everything on living in a manner that my 10-year future self would live. How confident is he? How wealthy is he in every area of life? How healthy? And you know what I mean? Like wealth, including health. And how does he show up powerfully in the world to make an impact and help others? It really is something that can take you out of your current situation. It can take you out of your negative headspace or a worrisome headspace or anxiety. And it can empower you and equip you really to show up in a way that is going to then yield impactful results, returns long term. In fact, the way I choose to live is, okay, if there was a 10-year future version of myself sitting next to me at all times, what would he say? What would he hope that I do in this very moment? How would he act? How many kids am I going to have at that time? How am I going to show up? So yeah, there are some differences. However, one of the main things that I found to really help push me has been, hey, you know, you're only going to be in this season for a short period of time. Enjoy it to the fullest. Embrace it. Make the most of it. Relish in the good things and persevere through the turbulence, because it's short-lived. This too shall pass. Whether good or bad, not enough focus on that. Whether good or bad, and those two terms being relative, I think we can all agree that good times mean, typically good times are going to include happiness, frequent happiness. They're going to include, it's going to be easier to be joyful in those seasons, so to speak. You know, maybe family life is great. Maybe finances are great. Maybe your clientele is booming. Maybe your business is exploding in growth, and maybe stress is at a low because you learn how to delegate effectively and execute on ideas rather than just doing the work and grinding. Even when life is good and bad, you know, this too shall pass. If you do get to a good place, you can sustain it. It is sustainable. However, don't over, it's typically, wait for this fire engine. So again, I'm recording this one on the Voice Memos app in my car, no microphone, just the smartphone, no microphone plugged in, just riffing off the mind, because I don't want to forget. So many people, yeah, how many people have you heard who say something like, if I knew then what I know now? Well, you can know now what you will know then. Let's dissect it, shall we? Look at that. Or if you knew then what you know now. Yeah, look at that. And that is a cop-out in the sense that if you continue to live like that in your life, in the sense that you keep showing up in a way that is reactive and almost hopeless because you're consistently thinking, I don't know now what I'm gonna know then. You can know more, though. You can talk to mentors. You can learn from elders. You can ask your peers who have done things that you haven't, who have gone places we haven't gone, who have been through things we haven't been through, and learn from their lessons and listen and embrace their pain and know what it is to feel that pain. I don't know if that's necessarily what you want to do, but be empathetic. You can learn empathy. You can reject apathy and learn empathy. That's going to be the title of this episode. Reject apathy and learn empathy. Empathy for your younger self, even. Two incredibly powerful activities that I recommend. Write out your eulogy, what you want people to say about you when you die. Write that out. Be dead honest about it, because if it's nothing like, oh, you're like, oh, it's not going to be anything what I want, wish it would be, write it out, because that will help your mind to start taking the actions to recognize, okay, you know, that doesn't support what I say I want my life to be about while I'm on Earth. So write that out. Take your time on that. I recommend listening to some dramatic music, anything it takes to get, you know, getting in that state. Vision board is good. Planning and goals. Yeah, vision board is good. I don't think that's what I was going to say, though. We were talking about reject apathy and embrace empathy. And then I said two incredibly powerful things that you can do. And the first one I was going to recommend, it already slipped my mind. Vision boarding is good as well. It can help you stay focused on what matters. Life happens, and I also get... What worries me is not having enough conversations like this with people one-on-one. We need these kind of conversations to keep us grounded, to keep us focused on what matters most, and it's a large part as to why I do these podcasts. I'm not even lying to you. These are sort of therapeutic for me. I hope that looking back on these 10-year future version of myself, that these are not very childish or overly self-centered or anything like that. I hope that these are relatable. And again, I always recommend take these with a grain of salt. I'm saying this as a journal entry and also hope that it would help people, because there are certain things that I do in my life that help me, and I'm not where I want to be yet. So I recognize that some of the things I say are flawed in the sense that they're not even supporting what I say or who I think I want to be and how I want to show up in the world. So I recognize that there are missing pieces. There are things I'm saying that may straight up not be accurate. So take that with a grain of salt, but also learn what you can. You know, I always love listening with peers. Talking with peers is so fun, and hearing their stories and things. There is a level of confidence that once you hit it, it becomes a lot easier to then forget to be a student of life. Don't forget to be a student of life always. Always remember, be a student of life. No matter how confident you get, no matter who you've become acquainted with or friends with, how much you've accomplished, always be a student in every area, because there's always somebody who's better at what you're doing than you are significantly. And everyone we meet, every single person is an expert in something we know nothing about. Every single person we meet is an expert at something we know nothing about. Everyone. Think about that. That's crazy, isn't it? Wow. Moving forward, guys. Yeah, also, if you're a person who's listening to these podcasts on the road, just a quick note of encouragement. In Europe, they typically drive like we're all going somewhere together. So, for example, the driver to my left and right, in front of, behind me, everyone drives in the sense of like, all right, we're all going to this destination. We're going to get there. No problem. In the U.S., people tend to drive like you're in my way. Move. That doesn't help anyone get there faster. It slows it down. But if you are driving, think of it like that. Think of it. It helps your mind to relax in terms of like, oh, they're trying to cut me off. It's like, no, just think about it. Everyone's getting to where we're going together. Consider others more important than yourself, and you actually get there faster typically. It's very ironic. Anyway, now the 10-year future version of yourself can remind you that no matter what season you're in right now, it's going to pass. It's going to go quick. Whether you get into a routine in this same setting, scenario, chapter, season, and it stays the same for 5 years, it's very unlikely. But if it is the case, good for you. Consistency is super powerful. So remember that. However, it's likely that 90% of things are going to change. And there's a C.S. Lewis quote that I absolutely enjoy. And it says, isn't it funny how day to day nothing changes, but when you look back, everything is different? Something to that effect. Isn't it funny how day to day nothing changes, but when we look back, everything is different? Isn't that so true of life? And it's reflective of the dynamic nature of life. It's all about rhythms. It can be challenging because, you know, happiness is fleeting, but don't let joy be robbed from you. Keep healthy perspective. Keep the attitude that no one can affect your... This is a tough one because it takes a lot of mental fortitude, but keep the belief that nobody can affect how you show up. There is part of our limbic system that naturally reacts to laughter of others, to things and emotions of others. It's built into us. So that's a fact. If you don't want to walk around with earplugs and an eye mask on to hide all of that out, so many people are, oh, if I knew now what I, or what if I knew then what I know now? And it's like, what about that now? What about that today? What about today? What about saying you can know now what you will know then if you implement the lessons of mentors, seek mentors, be a student, read books, study, take action, and learn. And yeah, there's going to be things that in time, that's natural, the natural progression of life that will occur. However, there are certain things we can do not to rush the destination. Hear me on this, not to rush the destination, but to understand that there might be more you can do. What else can I do? What else can I do? And yeah, you don't have control over your life particularly. We don't have control. That's sort of a farce. We don't have the ability to see the future. We don't know if we even have... We're not promised tomorrow. But while we're here, I believe it's our duty to show up. And that's what this episode has been about. So if you've enjoyed this episode, hit the subscribe button on whatever podcast platform you're listening to this on. Share it with one friend. Take a screenshot and post it to your Instagram stories and then tag at Heart Healthy Hustle. That's Heart Healthy Hustle, like Cheerios with hustle. And let me know your favorite takeaway from the episode, and I may very well hit you up or reshare your Instagram story post. Always be asking others, how can I help add value to your life? And do you know anybody who can help me? Do you know anyone who can help me as well? Always remember those two questions. Be willing to ask for help as well. It's not weakness. Not that it matters that it's a sign of strength, but it is a sign of strength. It's representative of a lot of strength. I hope you have an incredible weekend, one filled with joy, one filled with community, laughter, and productivity. And I will see you on Monday. As always, live wide open. Godspeed. Fearless. We'll be right back.